Welcome to MotoPress Hotel Booking Plugin. In this video, I will show how you can manage the bookings that you receive through your website. You will sure need it if you don't just display a list of your properties on your website, but also rent them out online. In regard to payments, we should talk about confirmation modes of bookings first. They are available under Accommodation Settings. There are three options. Confirmation by customer via email, but admin manually, or confirmation upon payment. The first one will send a confirmation email to the guest, and as soon as they follow the confirmation link in it, the booking status will be changed to complete. In this case, you can charge the guest upon arrival and add the payment information through the bookings tab. Confirmation by admin manually works almost in the same way. The administrator reviews a booking and changes its status. This mode is good for both online and offline payments. Using this mode, you can send payment details to your guests via email and control each booking yourself. The last one, confirmation upon payment, will change your booking status to completed as soon as the online payment is confirmed to be successful. As for the available payment gateways, they are all in the Payment Gateways tab. The General tab lets you define whether you want to charge a full amount or a deposit. And if it is a deposit, then whether it is a fixed sum or a percent and its amount. It is recommended to use an SSL certificate for better search engine scoring, and it is essential for security on web pages that process payments. So you can tick this box to make sure that your SSL certificate is used on your checkout page. Payment success page and fail transaction page are simple pages that contain a text notification about a payment result that your guests can see after a payment is made. This default gateway option will define the payment gateway that should be pre-chosen on the checkout page. Note that your guests will still be able to choose the gateway that suits them better. And this is the time that your guests will have to confirm the booking by paying. You may enable the test payment on your website to check the booking process flow. This will let you place bookings without actual payments. Now, each payment gateway tab has the enable box, so be sure to check the ones you are going to use. Each gateway has its options and a way of setting up. You need to follow the provided instructions. And note that some payment gateways like Stripe may not work without an SSL certificate. In this tab, all the bookings placed by the site visitors are listed with their statuses, check-in and check-out dates, numbers of guests staying, names, emails, and phone numbers, prices, the already paid amounts, and the dates of booking. We can also filter them by month and a guest's email or search by any other keyword. More detailed information can be found and managed by clicking on a booking ID. Let's have a look at this one. Here again we see the booking ID, check-in and check-out dates, all the information about the booked property and services, number of adults and children staying, and the chosen rate. Here are customer details, name, contact information, and any notes that the guest wanted to attach to the booking. In the additional information section, you see the discount coupon that was used, and you can even apply one if the payment hasn't been made yet. Then there is total price here, which you can also change, payment information, and the amount left to pay. You can also add a payment manually if it was made online. At the top of the page, we can change the booking status. There are six options: pending user confirmation, if there is any action the user needs to do, pending payment, pending admin confirmation, abandoned if one of the first ones were not completed on time, confirmed, and cancelled. And last but not least, the logs that record all the changes that were made to the booking. Both offline and online payments are listed here. If a payment or a part of it was made offline, you can add it directly through a booking order or through the payment history. Again, you can filter them by month or search by keyword. So, to create a new one, we click Add New. It already has an assigned unique ID. Choose a gateway. Manual payment can be used for offline payments, and the rest are there in case the payment was made not through your checkout page. So now enter the amount paid, currency, payment type, transaction ID, and assign a relevant booking. Here is the standard billing information. We can also add custom notes to the log of this payment and save it. We can also edit one of the existing payments, be it online or offline. As you can see, the payments may be pending, completed, failed, abandoned, on hold, or refunded. In the Calendar tab, you can see all the bookings and filter them as you wish. Then you can also create coupons. Add new, enter its code, description, discount amount, expiration date, accommodation types it can be applied to, check-in and check-out dates limits, minimum and maximum days of stay, and usage limit. And you will also see the number of times the coupon was used, so it's pretty handy for promotions. You can also synchronize bookings in case you rent out your property on booking platforms like Booking.com, TripAdvisor, Airbnb, and other online channels that support iCal format. Each real room has its calendar. Here are the internal links of these calendars that need to be inserted on other booking platforms, and these platforms provide external links for each room, which can be inserted here. Now you can update the availability information across booking platforms every time the calendars are synchronized. That's it! Make sure to subscribe to our channel and hit the notification bell to keep up with us. Thanks for watching!